Hello, I'm Jesse with American Radon Mitigation. I was called out to provide an estimate for activating this passive radon mitigation system. And we like to do diagnostics on everything just because I've ran into so many passive systems that just are not working properly. So we really don't just add a fan to it. We do diagnostics on everything. So this house, they have a 7-year-old daughter, very sensitive to chemicals. They got their radon test done Friday, tested at 3.2. It's now Monday. They want to get moving on this right away. I don't have time to do a full install right now. Typically, we spend half a day to a full day doing an install with diagnostics, even on activating a passive system. So for this instance, I do have time to kind of run a temporary system. So up on the roof here, we've located where the passive pipe comes out through the roof. It does go straight down 2 stories into the basement and into the concrete here. It is not tied into the sump basket, sump cover, which is pretty common here. So I've added this Fantech RN2 EC. Here's the fan, just temporarily got it running off a cord. We've got it set to 50%. And how I set this is the sump basket for the house is on that opposite corner. So I just had the customer go to the sump. I called him on the phone and then he used my puffer, which puffs smoke. And we set it so that it was just pulling the smoke down into the sump basket. So we're gonna let this run overnight until we come back tomorrow. We've got 4 eco trackers set up in the basement. So we'll have a pretty good idea. Even tonight, I can call the customer and have a good idea of what we're getting into tomorrow. You know, whether the radon levels are dropping or not dropping, you know, is really gonna help us determine how much time we might spend here or if this is gonna be a troubled system that we have to kind of troubleshoot, figure out why it's not working. But the fact that we're reaching from this side of the house to that side of the house is very good. All right, we are back. It is the second day. We had our temporary system installed and our radon levels overnight dropped from like that 3.2 level down to 0.7 in the basement, 0.6 on the main floor, and 0.5 on the second story. So we knew our passive system was going to work, which is always a crapshoot with the passive system. Since we didn't install it, we don't really know what's gonna happen, but doing that temporary system kind of gave us some more confidence coming into it this morning. So we've sealed the sump in the basement. John went around in the accessible areas like the storage room and the mechanical room and sealed the floor to wall joints that had opened up a little bit. They were sealed before, but that polyurethane had kind of pulled away over the last 6 or 7 years. So I've got the fan added here. I just cut out about 10, 12 inches of pipe. Added the fan. I've got the insulation pulled down over the fan so we don't get condensation dripping. And then we did a max depressurization test to set our radon fan to get our pressure field extension. It's a little weak compared to what we had last night, but we've got it dialed in. I was talking to John down in the basement who has given me my pressure field extension numbers, and then I would adjust the potentiometer here in the attic. So we went from the RN2 EC cranked up to 10, pulling 42 watts, dialing it down. We were able to cut it to 22 watts, which cuts the noise a little bit, but most importantly, it cuts the airflow so that we're not pulling so much conditioned air from the basement. So that's it for the attic. I'm gonna put the cover on here and I'll shut the lights off. They even had a light up here. And we'll head down to the basement to wrap up. I'm Jesse with American Radon. Thanks so much for watching.